GTA 4's PC port turned 15 years old recently, and for most of that time, this version of the game has admittedly been a disaster. Missing and broken graphical effects, poor performance, and a confusing number of versions, all with their own individual pros and cons, often make playing GTA 4 on PC seem like more hassle than it's worth. Thankfully, that is no longer the case. This year, significant progress has been made by the modding community to fix GTA 4 on PC. Modding has been made easier than ever, downgrading isn't really necessary anymore, and you can have the best version of GTA 4 on any platform by simply installing 4 excellent mods, and all it takes is a few minutes. So let's take a look. As always, don't forget to check the description and pinned comment for any updates on things that have possibly changed since this video originally went live, as mods often get updated and things like installation methods may change. For this video, I'll be using the complete edition of GTA 4. This is the latest version of the game that you get off of Steam and the Rockstar Games Launcher. Some people will tell you that you have to downgrade GTA 4. This simply isn't true. I have an entire video covering this debate, and I would recommend watching it if you plan on doing more modding with GTA 4. But for this video, you don't have to downgrade. We're just going to mod the version of the game you get directly off of Steam and the Rockstar Games Launcher. I won't be covering how to fix the game's performance in this video. The best way to fix performance is to use DXVK, but the results are very inconsistent between different PC hardware, and DXVK won't work at all on certain systems either. If you are interested in trying DXVK, you can follow my installation video after this video. If DXVK doesn't work for you, simply remove the files you installed and it will completely remove the mod. So let's start off with our first mod, FusionFix. This is going to be the most important mod we'll install, as it fixes a huge number of issues, adds a lot of quality of life features, and adds a mod loader called Fusion Overloader to the game. I'll quickly highlight some of the fixes this mod provides. The vanilla PC version of the game has an option called Definition. This allows you to enable or disable the game's motion blur when driving fast. But most importantly, it also enables or disables the game's depth of field effect. Except on the PC version of GTA 4, the depth of field effect is broken and instead blurs the entire screen instead of just blurring objects in the distance. You can see this in the comparison here, where even things up close get blurred. FusionFix separates motion blur and depth of field in the game's menu, so you can now enable and disable depth of field and motion blur separately, if you only want one or the other. FusionFix also fixes the depth of field effect. Like I said, previously it blurred the entire screen, and it didn't scale with resolution, so the intensity was only right at 720p. Now the effect scales correctly, and it only blurs objects in the distance like it was meant to. The mod also allows you to increase or decrease the intensity of the depth of field. The low setting is the same intensity as the depth of field effect in GTA 5, which is what I just used in this comparison. FusionFix fixes the rain effects. On the PC version of the game, the rain density was a lot less, and the splash effect was also missing. FusionFix fixes the awful Zed fighting seen in the PC version. If you gained any significant height in the PC version of GTA 4, you would see parts of the map flicker heavily. With FusionFix, this issue has mostly been resolved. The mod also enhances the game's shadows and adds some new shadow filter options. One that is especially nice is PCSS shadows, percentage closer soft shadows. This makes the shadows sharper when nearer to the object casting the shadow, and softer when further away from the object, similar to how shadows would look in real life. You can see this here, where the shadow at the start of this pole is sharper, as it's closer to the object casting the shadow, but the top of the shadow is softer, as it's further away from the object. You can also see how the shadow of the hot dog stand is sharp in contrast to the soft shadow next to it. With this option, you get a nice mix of sharp and soft shadows in situations where they're most appropriate. Like I said earlier, the mod also adds a mod loader called Fusion Overloader. You don't really need to know too much about it for this video, but if you do plan on installing more mods in the future, I'd recommend watching my tutorial for Fusion Overloader, so you know what you're doing. The mod adds so much more that I really can't even cover in this video, but if you are interested in learning more about what this mod does, I'd recommend reading through the mod's GitHub page. So anyway, let's download and install FusionFix. Step 1. Download the mod from the link in the description. Step 2. Open the mod archive you just downloaded and copy all of the files from the archive into your GTA 4 folder where gta4.exe is located. And that's it, the mod is installed. dinput8.dll is Ultimate ASI Loader, and it's used to load the FusionFix ASI plugin in the plugins folder, which provides some engine fixes and is also what allows Fusion Overloader to work. Fusion Overloader uses the update folder to load your mods, and this is where most of FusionFix is installed, and this is where our next mods will be installed too. Our next mod to install is Console Visuals. The PC version of GTA 4 changed a good few of the game's assets when compared to the console versions. Things like clothing options, animations, and other things were different between the two versions. The mod Console Visuals aims to restore all of that content from the consoles. Now, most of the changes are completely subjective. They're just small things like the way Nico might hold a specific weapon, or the size of the game's help boxes. But Console Visuals does come with one change which is definitely an improvement over the PC version, and that's the vegetation. On PC, a lot of the vegetation was changed. This includes a new grass model, which is actually worse because in a lot of areas it appears under the ground instead. Just look at this comparison here. The grass on PC is mostly under the ground compared to the console grass. As well as restoring the console grass, it also restores the console trees, although the trees have higher resolution textures than they did on console. As it turns out, Rockstar reused these tree textures in Max Payne 3 at a higher resolution. The team behind Console Visuals managed to extract those textures and got them into GTA 4 with some corrections made to them. FusionFix also allows you to toggle between different tree lighting, so you can use console trees with the console lighting, console trees with the PC lighting, or console trees with the PC lighting plus some enhancements such as vertex ambient occlusion on the tree models. Just to note, you can also switch between these different options even with the PC vegetation if you'd prefer to use that. Lastly, before we install, Console Visuals has two options for vegetation: Console Vegetation and Fusion Console Vegetation. I've been showing you Fusion Console Vegetation in this video, but the only difference between these two options is the alpha threshold. So the Fusion Console Vegetation option gives the trees a few more gaps between the leaves. Anyway, let's install the mod. Step 1. Download the mod from the link in the description. Step 2. Open the mod archive, open the CE folder, then open the next CE folder. Step 3. Pick whether you want Console Vegetation or Fusion Console Vegetation. I prefer Fusion Console Vegetation, so I'm going to pick that. Open the update folder in that folder and copy the Console Visuals folder to the update folder in your GTA 4 folder. And that's it, the vegetation from Console Visuals is installed. The penultimate mod we're going to install is Various Fixes. This mod fixes a huge number of issues with the GTA 4 map and other assets. It's hard to even cover what this mod fixes, as the list of fixes is so big, but this mod is definitely worth installing as it fixes plenty of texture issues, prop placement issues, and other problems and inconsistencies in GTA 4. Let's install the mod. Step 1. Download the mod from the link in the description. Step 2. Open the mod archive, then open the Installation Through Fusion Overloader folder, as we'll be using Fusion Overloader to load the mod instead of directly replacing the game files. Step 3. Open the update folder in the archive and copy all of the files from there into the update folder in your GTA 4 folder. And that's it. Various Fixes is now installed. Like all of the other old GTA titles, GTA 4 has had music removed due to licenses expiring. The radio station Vladivostok lost all of its original songs except one when licensing expired in 2018, so Rockstar added a whole new soundtrack to the station instead. And other radio stations also lost some songs too. Thankfully, we have mods to restore the missing music. The best mod to restore cut music from the complete edition of GTA 4 is the Radio Restoration mod. The mod provides some options when installing, so let's get to it. Step 1. Download the mod from the link in the description. Step 2. Right-click on the mod archive you just downloaded and click Extract All. Press Extract on the window that appears. Once done, open the folder which contains the extracted files. Step 3. Run ibceradiorestorer.exe and click Continue. Now, we have several options in front of us. We have the Only Pre-Cut Vladivostok Songs option. This restores the original Vladivostok station before the patch in 2018 replaced all of the songs with new ones. We have the pre and post-cut Vladivostok song option. This adds both the old and new songs to the radio station, so you get the original songs and the songs added in 2018. And we have the above plus 4 restored beta songs option. This option adds the pre and post-cut Vladivostok songs, while also adding 4 songs that were in the beta of GTA 4, but cut from final release. These 4 beta songs even have working DJ intro lines, so I'm not entirely sure why they were cut. Anyway, the option is up to you. Personally, I'm just going to use the only pre-cut Vladivostok songs option, as this is the way Rockstar originally shipped GTA 4. The mod also provides an option to install FusionFix as well, but we already have FusionFix installed, so we don't need to tick this box. Whenever you've made your choice, select Next. Step 4. Your game folder should automatically be detected by the Radio Restoration mod, but if it's not, click on Browse and locate your GTA 4 folder, where GTA4.exe is located. Click Install when you're ready. Once it's done, you've now restored all of the cut music from GTA 4. And that's basically it. This is probably the best version of GTA 4 you can play right now, with just 4 mods. Even the Xbox version of the game, which can be played at 60fps on Xbox Series consoles, suffers from a lot of these issues that these mods fix. And as well as that, that version of the game is locked to 720p, which isn't ideal on modern displays. The only issue you may have is performance can still be a struggle without top-of-the-line GPUs. I would recommend keeping GTA 4 locked to 60 frames per second or less, as certain things like bike physics break above 60fps. Anyway, that is finally all. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you give it a like. If you enjoy GTA modding videos, be sure to subscribe to the channel, and I'll catch you later.